unimaginable disaster. You'll see me guess time. It is impossible to estimate the damage, and they may flash streams in the area, but boy, the pipes are calling. In New York, Honolulu, Aris, Ohm, Austin, that old ace in the hole, past crimes feeling along your time. Enter George Raft, come Paris, in the spring, all his hands in his pockets, heavy with the Japanese Sandman, looking for someone who was trading new dreams for old. Unchain my broad. George Raft went home, tiring from films altogether, but available for civilian jobs once in a while. Sticky end for old Blackbird. Martin's reality film is the dreariest entertainment ever presented to a captive audience, he stated flatly. The opening scene shows a man sitting in the bar of a luxury hotel. Clearly, he has come a long way, travel-stained, and even the stains unfamiliar cufflinks of a dull metal that seemed to absorb light. The room buzzes with intrigue. Mauritania, uranium, oil, war. This man and what he sees are in the film. Clearly, portentous, exciting events are about to transpire. Now take the same man outside the film. He has come a long way and the stains are all too familiar. An American tourist confides in the bartender. Now, mother is down with a bad case of hemorrhoids and we don't speak the language. I tried to tell this doctor, at least he called himself a doctor, and I want your advice about the car. Oh, here's the man who took us to the Casbah. How much shall I give him? He pulls a wad of bills from his pocket, raw, eager thrust of an overtip, the magic gesture that makes a man bow three times and disappear into a dollar. A gnat has fallen into the man's sherry. Clearly, no portentous, exciting events are about to transpire. You will readily understand why people will go to any lengths to get in the film to cover themselves with any old film scrap, junkie, narcotics agent, thief, informer, anything to avoid the hopeless dead-end horror of being just who and where you all are. Dying animals on a doomed planet. Martin's film worked for a long time. Used to be most everybody had a part in the film, and you can still find remote areas where a whole tribe or village is on set. Nice to see, but it won't do you much good. Even as late as the 1920s, everybody had a good chance to get in the film. Well, he was dipping into the till. Just looks at me and says, account sheets are empty many years. The film stock issue now isn't worth the celluloid it's printed on. There is nothing to back it up. The film bank is empty. To conceal the bankruptcy of the reality studio, it is essential that no one should be in position to set up another reality set. The reality film has now become an instrument and weapon of monopoly. The full weight of the film is directed against anyone who calls the film in question, with particular attention to writers and artists. Work for the reality studio, or else. Or else you will find out how it feels to be outside the film. I mean literally without film left to get yourself from here to the corner. Every object raw and hideous, sharp edges that tear the uncovered flesh.